Hi guys, welcome to Java tutorials. Today's topic is Java statements. Statement overview or a definition of a statement. A statement in Java is like anything which we write in single line followed by a semicolon. Whatever statement, different types of statements available: declaration statements, expression statements, and control flow statements. Now we'll go for the what is declaration statement. Declaration statement will be followed by a declaration of a variable in order that the compiler to know that variable has been declared. Declare variable and its data type. First we have to mention the data type of the variable, then we have to mention the variable name, then equal to the value of the variable, initial value of the variable, and then followed by a semicolon. Expressions in Java can be considered as mathematical expressions. Also, a plus b equal to c, that is an expression. Every expression has to be followed by a semicolon, and in unary operations also considered as an expression. A plus plus also considered as an expression. Now next thing, it is method invocations such as method calls, which we'll explain later in this in the coming lectures. Method invocation means calling a particular method which has been written in Java. Now next one is control flow. Control flow statements are statements which we write in order to flow our program. In normal flow of Java is from top to bottom. If you write, the control flow statements allow us to write specific conditions so that our flow will be changed to particular locations. If loop, if else if, and nested else if. That is, there are the three types of control statements. We have to think like if statement is simply like if a particular boolean statement is true or false. If it is true, then it will enter the block followed by it. If condition and the braces, inside the braces we have to write our code. Else if else loop means if a condition satisfied, else we have to write the other condition. If the condition fails, if else if nested loop is like if we can write multiple conditions of like else if like that, we can write multiple conditions. Next one, control flow statement is while loop. While loop means if we want to particularly check a condition initially, and then we want to enter into a particular loop for n number of times. So we write a while followed by a condition and then braces. So in the braces we have to write the whatever the loop we want to execute. Do while loop is like an exit control loop where we will write the do statement first. Inside the do statement, we have to write the followed by do statement, there will be a brackets, and followed that we have to write the specific whatever the loop statements we have to write, that we have to write, and at the end we will write the while statement. That is why do while is an exit control loop. And the next one is for loop. For loop means we will write a particular loop. In for loop, it will be like for statement. It will be initial statement will be initialization, then we will write the condition, then the increment value, whatever the value we want to write the increment. For I equal to 0, for I less than n, I plus plus, for example. Next two, three statements which we use regularly to stop the flow or redirect the flow are break statement, continue statement, and return statement. Break statement will exit from the particular loop for a particular condition. If you write a break statement, then that particular loop will be skipped and the output will be flowing after that loop. Whatever we are created, whatever the block, that block will be exited after break. Next one is continue statement. Continue statement, for a particular iteration, if I write a continue for a particular condition, then it will skip that iteration and it will continue the further iterations. Next one is return statement. Return statements are written after the function, every function, so that it will return a particular value. If you write a return statement, the control flow will end of that particular function and it return to the parent method or parent call which we made. So that is the end of the today's lesson. We will see more videos in coming lectures. Thank you for watching the videos.